Greetings, brethren. Today we're going to be talking about Hebrews chapter 3. I pray the fresh Shekinah glory from God the Father, Yarevav, his throne in Zion, over all worlds, stars, sun, and moon, bless your souls from his heavenly glory, that you can open up your minds and your ears and your hearts to hear his holy word in fresh Shekinah glory light. Amen. Hebrews 3:3 in the Amplified. Yet Jesus has been considered worthy of much greater glory and honor than Moses. Just as the builder of a house has more honor than the house. Hebrews 3:4. For every house is built by someone, but the builder of all things is God. Understand now, the house and the builder. What did Moses build, and what was his house? What did the Lamb of God, our Messiah Jesus Christ, build, and what is his house? Are they different houses? Are they different builders? What's the building and the house talking about in Hebrews chapter 3? So we're going to dive in deep and understand the infrastructure of the building of the invisible world that Torah created. Now, Torah is the Hebrew word for instruction given to Moses by Jesus Christ, Angel Yarevave, on Mount Sinai. Okay, it's the Jewish religion. It's the rituals of the Jews. It's also our Christian Old Testament Bible. We know it's inerrant, infallible scripture. We know it's the creation story of the heavens and the earth in Genesis 1, how everything was made in the beginning. Now, what is the role and function of Moses today in New Covenant Christianity of Jesus Christ? A lot of Christians don't even read the Old Testament. Some Christians don't even understand anything about Torah and have neglected the wisdom of Moses, and yet Revelation 15 says all the overcomers of the end times are singing the song of Moses. So we cannot neglect the wisdom of Moses, but a lot of times in our charismatic infancy, we have become enemies of Moses' wisdom because we're trying to refrain from the law. So we don't understand the wisdom of the law. We don't practice the law of Levitical rituals, but we practice the wisdom of the patriarchs, which are called the men in white linen and the cloud of witnesses, righteous men made perfect. So we do need the Old Testament. In fact, Scripture says you can't even overcome as a New Testament, New Covenant Christian without the wisdom of Moses and the prophets entirely. It is one of the greatest errors in modern day Christianity that we neglect Moses and the prophets and all their significant wisdom. Here's why. Jesus has been considered worthy of much greater glory and honor than Moses, just as the builder of a house has more honor than the house itself. So here, I believe Apostle Paul, who wrote Hebrews, is saying the house itself is Moses, right? Jesus, considered worthy of much greater glory and honor than Moses. We know that because Jesus is the creator, Moses is the created. But Moses was faithful in all Jesus' house, it is written. So the builder of the house is Jesus. Just want to clarify that. People who watched Joel's Bar last night, we touched this very, very lightly. Let's go deep. Moses, here in Hebrews 3:3, is called the house. Now, we know we don't practice Moses' Levitical law. So what do we practice? The apostles of the Lamb say we practice the wisdom of the Old Testament. We practice the wisdom of the ages. We practice the wisdom of Moses and the prophets, for without that wisdom, we are literally not even in the house of God, Yarevave, at all. So a new covenant Christianity, apart from the house that Moses built, which is the infrastructure of the entire invisible world of angels. Write that in the comments. The house that Moses built in his assignment, his mission, is the infrastructure of the entire invisible world of earth, moon, sun, and stars. Truth, anyhow. So in order to live in that house, which is the messianic kingdom, why? Because Jesus came to fulfill Moses, not to do away with it, which means he's not obliterating that house. That house remains forever. Moses is scripture. We know that not one word of Torah will ever fade away from the heavens or the earth, ever. Heaven and earth, old heaven and earth will fade away, but the word, the Torah of Yahweh, remains forever, it is written. What does that mean? The way that Moses is understood in the invisible infrastructure world, that house, the house of sun, moon, and stars, the government of day, the government of night, Genesis 1 realities, that house remains forever. Now, what part of that house, the old heavens and the old earth, are obliterated? The human aspect of operation of that house. For when Messiah comes, you are no longer allowed to be a human being in that house. That's why those branches were cut off, and their branches in the heavenlies, Romans 11 says, of Israel and of the Jewish race, only for the time of the Gentiles to be engrafted in. And not just under the branches and under the angel's wings and under the trunk of Shekinah Tiferet, not just the lower rungs of earth and moon, but the whole trunk. And that's why a lot of Kabbalists of Klippoth Kabbalah, which is the current world system of the sorcerers of Babylon the Great, are very angry and very anti-Christ. Because in order to practice what Torah says here, the Torah of Apostle Paul, the instruction and teaching of Apostle Paul, in order to practice this, there must be a complete acceptance of Jesus Christ and his teaching. As Moses said, God will send one like me. Anyone who does not believe in him will be utterly cut off. Cut off from what? The ability of the infrastructure of the invisible world of moon, sun, and stars. To do what? Be outside the gates with the dogs and the sorcerers, it is written. Amen? Amen. So they're outside the gates until they receive the Messiah, Jesus Christ. Then they're welcomed in through faith in that name. Amen. And that name will obliterate their sorceries and forgive their sins and allow them to come into the gates of heavenly Jerusalem at any rung through the cross. For the cross is the pathway through all the sun, moon, and stars from earth to the very throne of Yahweh, Father God, in Zion's fullness of glory. For he is the light being of all light. He is the Shekinah being of all Shekinah. There is no light except for the Shekinah of Yahweh, the only God, the Father of Jesus Christ, and now our Father, by the Spirit of adoption, we cry Abba. Amen? So we're understanding Hebrews chapter 3, the house and the builder. Now, I'm an apostle of the Lamb. I am building in this house, and this house is already built, as it's written, I go and prepare a place for you, that where I am, you may be also. In my Father's house are many mansions. These mansions are the rungs of going from glory to glory, dimension to dimension, by the circumcision of the cloud of witnesses and the angels of every angelic sphere, and that's the truth anyhow. Put that on repeat and memorize it and let it be burned on your spirit, that you may rise out of the center of the earth under the minerals, plants, animals, and human beings in dust and dirt in what is written, Daniel 12, to shine like the stars and the brilliance and the radiance of the heavens forever. For many shall arise out of the center or dust of the earth, which is all the sins, transgressions, and iniquities of human beings in agreement with the liars of the fallen angels. For all of that will be washed away from you as you rise from the center of the earth to stand on top of the earth as overcomers of the earth's sphere. Then, if God permits, you can go to the moon. Revelation 12:1. And I saw a woman standing on the moon. Who is this woman? This is the bride of Christ. This is the bride of Torah, the bride of the word and the teaching of the Messiah Jesus Christ. For she is an overcomer of earth and moon, and she is clothed in the sun and wearing a crown of 12 stars, with all planetary systems and constellations of time and space under the control of her renewed mind of Christ. And that's your destiny if you are to obey his commandments and love him with all your heart and lay your life down for him and become his servant and a disciple of Jesus Christ in the kingdom of heaven. All these things are in store for you in Jesus' name. I bless your souls. Amen.